welcome to Tim Anderson Horse Training. Today, this morning, while I have the cows and the horses all brought in, I have a couple projects I want to do out in the pasture, and I was going to take you along with me. So here we go. So we're in the tractor right now. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to take the arena drag off the back, and we'll take the bucket off of the front. And as you may have seen in some previous video, I don't have any a forklift attachment, but I have something that I use to move arena panels around. So we'll take the bucket off and we'll put those boards on and then get working. So first we'll take the arena drag off of the back. Noticed or not, but the lift arm was extended out on one side. Hope I wasn't dragging the arena like that, but I probably was. Have to watch for that next time. Now we're going to move over and put the hay spear on. The bucket off the front end loader. Took the bucket off the front, put those boards on, that's what I use the lift panels with, and I'm going to head over to where I have those panels stored, and so I have a couple with some bent legs on them. I'm going to pick them up, and there's a place I want to put them out in the pasture. You can see off to the side over here, they've been working on my arena, and got probably a day and a half from finishing, and we got a bunch of rain, so now we're waiting for it to dry so they can finish my working the dirt for my big arena. Thank you. cleared because of this power line. Hopefully you can hear me over the truck. I'll let down a little, maybe that'll help. Where the power line crosses it, I have a couple of guy wires. So what I'm going to do is take these panels that have these bent legs. They're really not good for to use as panels. And I'm going to put them up against the guy wire to make a kind of a safety guard so the horse don't run into it and get hurt. The other thing I'm going to do with this bale of hay, I'm going to put it in this area where the power line is. This is all cogon grass. If you're from the south, you're probably familiar with it. It's an invasive grass species. I think I'm going to go to the other power line first, another guy wire. It's an invasive grass species, and the animals can eat it, but they only eat it when it's short and tender. And once it gets tall, it's harsh and rough, and they really don't like to eat it, but it really doesn't have any nutritional value either. So I'm going to take this bale of hay. This hay was just cut. This year's cut, and it was only cut like 3 weeks ago. So it's very fresh hay, and it has some grass seeds in it. So what I'm hoping to do with it is put it out here and let the horses eat on it, spread it out. I'm not going to put anything around it, any bale feeder or anything. I know a lot of it's going to get wasted as far as not getting eaten, but it's going to get spread around in this cogon grass. I hope start to choke it out and some good grass to start coming up in this place. So here we are with this guy wire that I want to put a brace up against. We'll stop right here. And we'll go tie this fence post to this guy wire, or fence panel rather. I'm just using some regular steel tie wire, nothing special about it. I will double it so it'll be a little stronger. And I'm just going to tie this panel to this guy wire. Hopefully just be a bigger visual reminder to the horses and cows. I do rotate my pastures. So sometimes there'll be horses in here, sometimes there'll be cows. Just a bigger visual reminder that they need to stay off of this guy wire. Pretty simple thing to do to possibly eliminate, alleviate, whatever the word is. a potentially serious problem. If he was to have a horse running around and catch his neck on this guy wire, he could hurt himself really seriously. That was pretty simple and easy thing to do to prevent a pretty catastrophic accident. So there's one down. It's not gonna go anywhere. We'll go do the other one. This one's a good bit heavier than the other one. I wanted to put that shorter one over by that other guy wire because that was not too far from a cross fence. And I didn't want to take up any more space than what I had to because of being close to that cross fence. This panel has definitely seen better days. Alright, I think we're good there. Put this back in the tractor. I'll set my hay down. Put it somewhere over there where I want to knock the cogon grass down. Then we'll go get some horses ridden. Okay, so I'm sure you can see the roll of hay behind me. Put this back over here. I'll go cut the strings off that hay and we'll leave it right here. This and having a mold problem. If I only had a couple horses, it would definitely be an issue. But this roll will only last about 3 days. It's not gonna mold that quick. And that will actually break down to about 70 pounds of hay per horse per day. Which is more than what they need in one day, but if they're on the hay for a couple days and then they're off the hay for a couple days, and you let it average out to about 40 to 50 pounds per day, it works out about right, because they'll eat the hay and then they will kind of lay around and digest it. So that's today's project. I want to thank you for watching. We'll go get a couple of horses ridden now, and I'll be posting videos of getting those worked here really soon. Thanks for watching.